Alright guys, so today we are showing off the EZA for Int Rage Trunks, and he is actually very good. So we're going to lead off by breaking him down. If you don't know what he does, feel free to skip forward in the video a little bit. If you're rocking with me, let's go. So his leader skill, he gives super class 3 key and 100% stats. I think I might be actually taking him into the super stage of Super Battle Road as the leader actually. Maybe not tomorrow, but probably the day after that or the day after that. I'm not real sure actually. But be looking out for that video, because that video is actually going to be a lot of fun for me personally, just because this guy comes from my favorite era of Dokkan. And, I mean, if I think about it, his leader skill was probably my favorite of all time to use when he first came out. He gave 1 key and 70% to heroes, and like, you ran him as your lead, and then you ran a physical Vegito Blue friend. That team was so fun. Anyways, I just got off on a tangent. So on super attack, he causes immense damage to enemy, he greatly lowers defense, and he raises super class allies attack by 30% for one turn. None of that's really good. I mean, it's something, I guess. I should also mention he's rainbowed. So his passive, he changes STR key spheres to int key spheres. He gets attack and defense plus 20% per key sphere obtained, and then he randomly changes key spheres of a certain type, excluding int and STR, to rainbow when you're facing a Realm of Gods category enemy. And if you get 7 or more key spheres, his attacks are effective against all types. So a lot to talk about from his passive, actually. There's a lot that got buffed here. So before, it was just attack plus 15% per int key sphere. So not only did he get 5% more attack, 20% more defense, but he also doesn't need int spheres anymore. Well, like, int spheres are probably what you're going to be getting him anyway, but it's just because he does make int spheres, right? But it did kind of feel weird, because if you had another orb changer on rotation with him, and they changed int, then he was just screwed. He got no attack at all. But just all that really helps, as well as the fact that, like, in a legendary Goku event, let's just say, between, like, him making int spheres and him making the rainbow spheres, most of the time he's going to be super effective against all types, so he's actually going to be a very interesting option in the legendary Goku event. We're probably going to take him in there tomorrow, I'm pretty sure. So his passive, really, it's looking good. Links, he has Super Saiyan, Golden Warrior. Sorry, I'm getting distracted. I'm attempting to kill an ant that is on my desk. I should probably cut this out, but I didn't. I lost it. I'm sorry. What was... Oh, yeah, Links. That might be the most unprofessional thing I've ever done. Whatever. Link skills, he has Super Saiyan, Golden Warrior, Royal Lineage, Messenger from the Future, Dismal Future, Prepared for Battle and Fierce Battle. Overall, just a pretty standard Link set for a Super Saiyan unit in this game. And then categories, he is actually on, like, what is that, 7 categories? That's pretty good. He's on Hybrids, Future Saga, Time Travelers, Vegeta's Family, Super Saiyan, Bond of Master and Disciple, and Revenge. We're going to be showing him off on Future Saga first, then probably Vegeta's Family, and then lastly we're going to be showing him off on Time Travelers here today. Now, I've already spent 3 minutes breaking him down. Now, one thing about the Future team, like, if you look at this team, you might be like, hey, Kid Gohan's not from the Future Saga, and you'd be right. But the thing about running this team is you can run, like, the Tech Trunks, his leader, his secondary leader skill, he gives all super class allies 120% stats. So, I mean, if you run Kid Gohan with his Trunks, let's just see what his attack stat is here. Remember, he doesn't even have, like, Super Saiyan active. This is going to hurt a lot for this Gohan. I got this Gohan one orb. I know you didn't see me click an orb with him. I got him one orb. All right, so that's 3 million attack stat that is super effective against all types. So that's really, like, a 4.5 million attack stat. It didn't do any damage, but that's just because of the event we're going against. That was a very, like, that's a rotation you're never, ever going to see, because you're probably not going to run that Kid Gohan on the Future Saga team very often. But for a showcase, you can just do whatever you want. That's the best part. Here there aren't any red orbs or purple orbs, so I'm not really sure what to do. So here I think I'm actually probably going to float off this Vegeta. Because while it is cool to see Gohan, well, Trunks with that Gohan on rotation, and that is something you can do on, like, Hybrid Saiyans, whereas, like, if you have, int Future Gohan, that might actually be, like, a fun rotation to run, just see how that works. But because I do not, I mean, there's really no place where you can actually run them, except for on this team, which, I know I've already said this, but you won't do that. but I think I'm actually going to float off that Gohan next rotation, just to see where he's at without it, because remember, that Gohan, not only did he change orbs of, like, a random type to int there, so we got Trunks more orbs than we could have, he also gave 50% support. I mean, he didn't give him any links, though, so that is, like, another thing to keep in mind. I think the only link they were sharing was, like, Prepared for Battle, which is obviously just a key link. Alright, so here, please change blue. No, he did not. Okay. Huh. Alright, I think I'm going to leave... Yeah, I'm going to leave Rose up front here, and then I'm going to get all these blue orbs with Trunks. So that was still a good amount of orbs. I forgot to check his defense last turn. Here's defense. 133,000. That's pretty good. This Trunks, I'm just going to tell you right now, he would be a lot better if... Instead of, like, greatly lowering defense of the enemy and, like, raising superclass allies attack by 30% for one turn, if he just, like, greatly raised defense for one turn, he would be a completely different unit. Like, if he just had AGL Rose's super attack effect, he would be so much better. Because, I mean, sure, 130,000 defense, it's pretty good, but do keep in mind, right now, okay, 3.1, pretty good attack stat there. But do keep in mind, that was with 50% defensive support, as well as, like... What was that, 8 or 9 orbs? So, I mean, that was a very solid defensive stat, but it's like, this is a very pretty unreal, a very pretty, what did I just say? It's a pretty unrealistic setup that I just had there. Speaking of unrealistic setups, next turn I'm going to float off, well, not next turn, but this turn I'm going to float off LR B-Pan, and then after we get LR B-Pan on rotation with this team, I think I'm actually going to cut over to the Vegeta's family then. And because we do have B-Pan on this team, I'm not going to use B-Pan on Vegeta's family, even though you can, because Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta does give that secondary buff to Super STR. But I just feel like seeing B-Pan's active skill once is fine enough. Okay, so next turn we'll have the Vegeta, actually. So Vegeta is going to give 30% support, but he's not going to be buffing, like, well, not buffing, but he's not going to be changing orbs. So this is just going to be Trunks changing orbs. Let's see where we're at. Oh, and that's actually a... decent amount of orbs. So, I don't know what to do. I guess I'll leave Vegeta on rotation here. We can do that. That is 3, 6. Okay, that's 8 orbs. Now here, he doesn't have the... okay, so down to 117. He is fully easy 8, right? I'm making sure I didn't mess up too much, because I remember his defense being higher. Wait, is this 130% defense team, though? It is. Okay. So unlike Vegeta's family, his defense is actually going to be a lot better, because he's going to be getting an extra 80% defense just from the leader skills. Okay. Because I remember when he first came out on JP, I watched, like, the Truth Showcase, and I was like, oh, his defense is actually very good. But on this team, his defense is not quite as stellar as I would have hoped. Are we going to die here? I didn't really pay much attention. Okay, no, we're fine. All right, so here this Trunks, 2.8. In every single rotation, we have gotten him at least 7 orbs, so he's been super effective against all types. So, I mean, he was hitting way harder than Rose. Okay. Because it may have looked like, oh, his attack stat was only 100k higher, but because he was super effective against all types, it's really like a 1.5 times multiplier on top of what his actual attack stat was. So that was really good. Okay. Just no damage there. And, alright, just after next rotation, I think we are finally going to cut... So, there, it's funny, there are literally no red orbs. There are still no red orbs. I did bring an item, but I'm not going to use an item. Just out of principle, because we've seen him in a lot of good situations. So, if, like, the one time we see him in a realistic rotation is when we have LRB fan on rotation, I mean, I guess that's okay. I mean, next rotation, he's not going to have Fierce Battle, and there aren't going to be many red orbs. So, even though we're going to have B-Pan and that Vegeta, it's actually not going to be, like, his quotes up max attack stat or whatever. I'm sorry if you guys heard that. I just moved my entire desk because I can speak English, I swear. Over the course of the day, sometimes my desk just moves backwards. Also, one thing I should say, I'm sorry. Yesterday, a video didn't go out until a few hours like later than it normally is supposed to. I know a lot of people probably don't know this, but every day at noon Central Time, there is a video up on this channel. But yesterday it was a few hours late, and by a few hours, I mean actually 7 hours late. And the reason for that is because lately, I haven't been recording videos at all. I haven't recorded a video in like 2 weeks, because, I mean, I'm just gonna break the fourth wall here a little bit. I recorded a lot of videos in April. So I don't know exactly how many days were in April. Alright, so hold up, before we just go on that. 52,000 defense right here. We're going to get him all these orbs. And he is at 117k. Pretty good defense. But I'm not sure how many days are in April. But I'm pretty sure I recorded like 50 videos. and I've just been like... All of the comparison videos. Like Yesterday we dropped Frieza versus Frieza, you know, the final form Friezas or whatever. All of those videos were recorded in April. And one bad part about that, as I'm figuring out right now, is some of them I can no longer release. Because one of them I did was like AGL Rose. Okay, 3.3 million is a pretty good attack stat. I mean, this rotation is not very realistic at all, but it's still a pretty good attack stat. But one video I did was AGL Rose versus STR Rose. But because I recorded it literally over 3 months ago at this point, that was before AGL Rose even had his Dokkan Awakening, so I have to like re-record that video. What am I even talking about anymore? Whatever, we're going to cut over to the Vegeta's family team, and we'll be back in a second. Alright, so we are back here on the Vegeta's family team, and we actually got pretty unlucky here. Because last rotation, so on the Vegeta's family team, there is a pretty cool thing you can do. Where it's like, you can put this guy, this Majin Vegeta, next to this guy. And what that's going to do is Majin Vegeta is going to change blue orbs into red orbs, and then Trunks is going to change those red orbs into purple orbs. And then you're pretty much just going to have a full field nuke without using any items, which is pretty cool. But because we one-turned the Super Saiyan 1 phase, which I did not think we were going to do, we actually don't have that here. We will actually have it next time, though, because I floated off Majin Vegeta. So this is probably going to be the least amount of orbs we're going to get in the video, and we have no support. So overall, this is probably going to be his worst damage in the video, even though his defense here is, I think, the highest we've seen all video just because of the higher defensive leaders. So let's see what he gets to here. He's probably going to take very little damage, if I had to guess. Okay, so yeah, double digits. I mean, this is just a Dokkan event, so the damage he's taking doesn't really matter as much. 2.3 million attack stat, definitely not bad. And considering, okay, we got a crit there, which means it didn't matter that we got the 7 orbs. But we did get 7 orbs. And there, his changing key spheres to rainbow actually kind of hurt us. Because if you saw that, there were too many rainbow key spheres to where we couldn't get them all. If this is set up right, this is going to be a really nasty turn next turn. It is set up right. So Majin Vegeta, see all those blue orbs? As soon as Majin Vegeta shows up, they're going to turn red. And then right after that, they're going to turn purple. So this is going to be a gross turn. Oh no. Actually, yeah, this sucks. Never mind. Because we're going up against such an easy event, Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta is just going to finish this off. So the orbs that we set up does not matter at all. Actually, please don't double super. Either, like, the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta or Bra. Don't think I was just talking to Bra there. Why did I have to get a dupe for my Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta? Please, just stop. No, he did it. Dang it. That would have been such a good look at him, though. Dokkan events are so much easier than I remember them being. Alright, either way, this is a very good-looking turn. Yeah, I'm actually just going to do that. And then, oh my gosh, that's almost like a full field. Here, his defense is at pretty much 200,000. 198,000 defense is very good. Let's see what his attack stat gets to here. Obviously, he's going to be super effective against all types. So, whether he crits or not, his damage here is going to be good. And, like, this is a rotation you can run. So, 3.8 million without any support, mind you. That's pretty good. I don't know why I didn't float off Bra. On the Vegeta's family team, we didn't see him with support one time. Because I just never floated off Bra. That's my fault. And I don't think we're going to get to see that either. Because I don't think we're going to finish this off here. But, I mean, we're going to finish it off pretty soon, I think. So, I can do that. If they're set up right, which I'm actually not sure if they are anymore, next rotation should be pretty good for Trunks as well. But, I mean, just once again, no support. We're just going to have Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta in the last slot. But, I mean, the Majin Vegeta Rage Trunks setup is actually something I might run a little bit more, just like when I'm farming events, just because it seems pretty fun, just from what I've seen so far. And, I mean, really, that's what matters in Dokkan. It's not like it's difficult anymore. Although, like, if they want to make it more difficult, I'm there for it. Like, if they want to release Extreme Super Battle Road during the 5-year, which I think is very possible, by the way, I would be all down for it. Because, I mean, I want the game to be difficult so bad. And I know that might just be, like, me because I'm kind of a whale. I'll say I'm a dolphin. So it's like I want to use my units. I'm actually going to float off. I'm going to do this. Because this is a way I can get the most orbs and still have my links active here. So here we got a few less orbs than we did last time. That is no big deal, though. And we can actually still get a lot of orbs with Majin Vegeta as well. Yeah, this setup is actually pretty, nice. Alright, so attack stat here should be a little bit lower. 3.64, though, with super effect against all types is still crazy. Yeah, that does finish off Vegeta. We're actually going to take him onto a mono purple. No, mono int. I've been playing a lot of Dragon Ball Legends lately, I'm sorry. We're going to take him to a mono int Time Traveler's team and just see how he works over there. We'll be back in a second. Alright, so we are back here. We are on a Time Traveler's team, and as you can see, we are running mono int. And the reason I'm doing this, well, there are multiple reasons, actually. One, it's because Trunks on this team is so useful, because he makes so many Inky Spheres. And the second reason is just because it seemed fun, and that's why I do things in Dokkan now. we got the rotation that we wanted to get at the end of the video, right now, but the only problem is we don't have Super Saiyan 3 Bardock's passive active, so it's not going to be quite as good, because we do have Mai on the back end giving the 40% support, but Bardock is only going to be, linking good here. He's not going to be giving any support himself, which is kind of a bummer. But I think next time we see him, because we just got supered, he is going to be giving support. Actually, he didn't take enough damage there, surprisingly. But there was, 2.4 million? One thing to keep in mind here is on the other two teams, he was under double 170% attack. Here he's only on 150% attack, which is, definitely a significant drop down as far as attack goes. Just for funsies, I'm going to pop this. So this is going to change all of the blue orbs into red orbs. And then next turn, Trunks is just going to eat. Yeah, that's going to be a whole lot of orbs for our boy Trunks. I mean, I know this is... I guess these showcases really aren't meant to be realistic. These showcases, the ones that I do first, are really just to show, the peak of the unit. And then, the showcases after this are the ones where it's supposed to be, realistic. When I take him into Legendary Goku Vent, when I take him into Super Battle Road, those are more realistic showcases of the unit, I guess I could say. Okay, that hurt a little bit. We actually do have Super Saiyan 3 Bardock's passive active here. You know what I just realized? I'm trying to keep Super Saiyan 3 Bardock's passive active here, but this is going to heal up pretty much all of our health. Yep, that's just about all of our health back. He's at about 200k defense. Okay. I mean, this attack stat should be pretty good, though. His attack stat is 4 million, okay. I mean, because he's a nuker, he doesn't really have, a max attack stat unless if you use the full field nuke and stuff. But I think on this team, you could really get him, over 5 million probably, with super effect against all types. I mean, as crazy as that sounds, I'm not sure if that's unrealistic. And next turn, if I just pick that green orb, I'm pretty sure we can get, a lot of orbs with Trunks again, even without any items. So, I think we're going to get the rotation with Mai one more time. And then after that, we're probably going to call this a video, because I'm actually not sure how long this video is. But I'm pretty sure this is one of the longer just showcase videos that I've done. And most of the time, the showcase video is about 12 minutes long. And then, the Super Battle Road video and the Legendary Goku event video are a little bit longer. Huh, you know what, actually, I'm going to do here? I'm actually going to give all of these orbs to... I don't know what I'm going to do here. Because I don't want to heal. This is my thing. I don't want to heal. Goku Black doesn't have any defense. We're going to give him all that. And the friend Goku Black was actually just 55%. So I know this may look weird. So this is actually going to be by far the lowest attacks that we've seen from Trunks all video. Because we got him one orb, I'm pretty sure. So this is going to be very low. That is going to do a lot of damage to Bardock, though. Perfect. He's still over a million. He's not super effective against all types, though. So, overall, that attack stat was pretty low. When we get the bad attack stat is when he double supers, of course, just because that's how this game works. Okay, so we just have to survive next turn, and we should have his best, his quotes up best rotation, right? Okay. I can just use a King Yama, I think I did. I hope I brought a King Yama. Okay, that sucks. This is bad. Why didn't I bring a King Yama? We could die. If we die here, I'm just gonna cut. I'm just gonna be honest here. I am also gonna use the Poor, because I can. Okay. So, that is... please don't die, is what I'm saying. A fly just flew in my ear. I'm sorry. There's bugs everywhere, I guess. Okay, please just don't super this turn at all. That would be perfect if we just didn't get supered. Oh, it would also be nice if we didn't finish this off. Goku Black, don't double super? Okay, perfect. No supers at all. Just what I wanted. Okay, so this is the rotation here. This is actually probably going to be the best attacks that we've seen all video. So let's check his defensive stat. That was a lot of orbs. Still under 200k. It's not... I don't know what to say here. I was going to say it's not realistic to get him over 200k, and then I was going to say it was. So 4 million, I mean, times 1.5, that's like a 6 million attack stat there because of his super effectiveness against all types. So this Trunks is actually pretty good. I think tomorrow I'm probably going to take him into the Legendary Goku event, and then probably the day after I'm going to take him into Super Battle Road, probably using his leader skill. That's probably going to be fun. Be sure to watch both of those videos as soon as they go up. But if you guys did enjoy this video, please consider to leave a like, a comment, subscribing to the channel. My name has been Blaho Ru, and I'll see you guys next time.